Hi, this is Dimmy K. If you are a new artist without label that just created their first track and you're wondering on which platform you should upload it, then I have the answer to you. You need to upload it everywhere, and I'm going to tell you how and why. Everything I'm going to discuss today comes from personal experience, and it applies mostly to people who have no labels or no managers or no marketing budget behind them. You are just a new artist, you created a song or an EP or an album, and you want to share it with people. I'll tell you how to do that and why you should have it everywhere. First, you need to understand that people enjoy to listen to their music in different platforms, and not on one specifically. So your goal, even as an unsigned artist, is to have your music available for everyone. Luckily, there are many free platforms out there, like Bandcamp, SoundCloud, Audius, etc. So you can have your music without paying anything. I will explain to you where you need to have your music and how much it might cost, like a total cost in the end, which is not more than $20. Let me show you on my PC, so you can follow. Let's begin with Bandcamp. This is one of the most known platforms out there. It's free, totally free, and you can upload as much music as you want. The great thing with Bandcamp is that you can have everything in one place, and you can have them tidy and neat and beautiful and look great. You can add your bio over here, your information. You can design your own page as you like it, make a banner for you, and then if we go directly to an album, for example, you can have all your tracks here, you can have info, who made the album, what's the album about, if there is a story behind it, and everything. You can also add reviews for the album, you can add your links, or you can do it here. And you can see your sales and reviews from your fans. You can set your own price. You can offer an album for free if you wanted. You can have your whole digital discography on offer, like I have here, 80% off. You just need to link your PayPal account and you get paid immediately after a sale. I have many artist friends that swear on Bandcamp. They pay their bills from it. And it's indeed a great platform. The great thing with Bandcamp is that you can design it as you like. You can have it be very personal and look beautiful. You can also add merchandise if you have it, like CDs, tapes, t-shirts, etc. And the other great thing is that you can send a message to your followers. If someone follows you and you have a new album or a new release out, you can create a post, like this here, like what I did, send it, and it will appear on their email. Now, don't spam emails to fans, because they will unfollow you, and it's not polite. In my opinion, only if you have something new that you want to share, send a message. Second platform that you should use is Spotify. There are many artists that don't like Spotify because of the way it pays, and I will explain more about that later, but my opinion is that you should have your music everywhere. Now, Spotify is not that beautiful as Bandcamp. It's a bit of a mess. For example, EPs and singles are in the same place over here. Albums are in different place. If I check my singles, you notice that it's not like the most beautiful design ever. Even if I go to each album's or EP's page, there is not much info that you can get about the album. If you look here on Bandcamp, you'll see that I have a whole story here. Who made the album, where the inspiration came, and the reviews, for example. Here, you have only the music, nothing else. The good thing with Spotify is that, first of all, you can use it as portfolio. For example, a PR song. This is all the tracks that I have worked for other artists. So when I want to find a new job, or I want to show my skills, for example, I can use this page and show what I have done in the past. On Spotify, you work in two ways. First of all, with playlists. For example, I have an Undiscovered Synthwave playlist. Okay. You can have your music there, and then you have the potential of, in this example, 800 people checking your music the moment it releases. There are other playlists out there with many more followers, and they can get you an audience pretty fast, if you manage to get on them. And how you do that is you go to the playlist, for example here, you find the creator, the curator, you search on Facebook, Twitter or Reddit, and if you find them, then you send them a nice polite message submitting one or two of your tracks. You'll find that most often than not, people will add your music to their playlists. So you don't have to only make it on one big playlist with like thousands of listeners. If you make it in a lot of small ones, you'll get the plays. The other great thing with Spotify is the followers. If someone checks your music and they like it, they can follow you. And next time you release something, your music will appear on their release radar. That's a great thing, because if you have like 10 people following you, then it means your new EP will be listened by 10 people. If you have 100 followers, then you have 100 plays. You have 1,000, it goes on and on. Now, the problem is that you cannot upload on Spotify or iTunes or Amazon Music or whatever on your own. You need a distributor like DistroKid or CD Baby. I personally use DistroKid for the reason that it's like $20 per year. The problem that I found with CD Baby, for example, which is one of the biggest out there, is that you need to pay that much money, like $10 for a single or $30 for an album. And if you are a creative person and you have a lot of music that you want to release per year, then this adds up. And in the beginning, as an indie artist, most probably you won't make that money back. That's why I went with DistroKid. I thought, okay, I'll pay $20 once per year, see what happens with Spotify and the other platforms. So, here's what happened with DistroKid. You can upload your music, as much music as you want, yes, and after a few days, your music will appear on all these platforms here. For example, Spotify, Deezer, Apple Music, Amazon, Anghami, I have no idea what that is, TikTok, Twitch, everywhere. You will have your music everywhere. And that's the goal, to have your music available for every person to listen to it. The other great thing with DistroKid is the automatic split payments. Let's say you want to collaborate with a friend and you want to share everything 50-50 because you both made the track. If that person also has DistroKid, they can generate a code, then you come here, you add the code, and you join the splits. It's like two clicks. It's so easy. I, for example, have collaborated with a lot of my friends, and splitting the earnings is pretty easy for us. For example, here, you have Turbonite, Weapon, and me. We share everything. I like to collaborate with my friends and make music, and that for us is a blessing, to be able to share the streams so easily. The problem with DistroKid though is that it's one payment per year, but if you happen to miss a payment, then all of your music might disappear. And that's the worst thing that can happen. With CD Baby, if you upload once, then it stays up there forever. So you pay $10 for a single, it will be there forever. Back in the day, I didn't trust the distributors or Spotify. I didn't understand why I should have my music up there. And I was afraid to pay money in order to do that. And that's why I chose DistroKid, because it's like $20 per year. I can give $20 per year, it's not that hard. So I started uploading my music on Spotify in 2018. And that's like 3 years after my first album release. Now, that's for you to decide. That's a personal thing. In my opinion, as a new artist, it's a good thing to test the waters. Don't go overspend money if you don't have them. Pay once in DistroKid, see if the streams work for you, if you have sales on iTunes or Amazon or whatever, if you have streams on Spotify, and then if you see that you make your money back, then the next time you can choose a different distributor, like CD Baby. Now, I'm not sponsored by either of them, by any distributor, but I do have a referral link from DistroKid. So if you want to get a 7% off, then you can use the link in the description. So by now we talked about Bandcamp and the way to have your music up on Spotify, on Apple Music, iTunes, Amazon, etc. And those are the main platforms that you actually need. But you can take another step further. For example, SoundCloud. Back in the day, SoundCloud was one of the best platforms. You can upload your music for free, you can gain followers, but the only thing that you get back is those likes, nothing else. And those do not help the artist. Now they added a monetization program, but I haven't tried it, so I don't know what it does. Personally, I believe that SoundCloud is pretty much dead. I rarely use it. For example, I uploaded Viral Vector 9 months ago, and only today I uploaded a new song from my latest EP. 9 months later. I don't use it, yes, but at times I update it and it does have its audience. I think for different genres, like hip-hop or trap or something like that, the audience might be more important and SoundCloud can help artists to be discovered. But in my experience, it doesn't help me much. The other alternative that you can use is Audius. This is a recent platform. It works like SoundCloud. You can upload as much music as you want. As they say, you can upload everything from remixes, covers, whatever, and you won't get a strike or you won't get your account deleted. And their thing is that they pay in cryptocurrency. They say that to generate it, you need to upload music and interact with other artists. But I haven't seen any constant payment like in Bandcamp where it's immediate, or in Spotify and DistroKid that it pays once every 3 months. The fact is that it doesn't hurt to try. Final platform that I'm going to talk about is YouTube. YouTube is probably one of the most difficult platforms to be discovered. And even to get paid, you need to have more than 1,000 subscribers and like 4,000 hours of content viewed. What you should do is create a free account, because it's free, and upload your music as albums, as full albums, in one video, and as separate songs. Whenever you have them. The thing is that YouTube is the second biggest search engine in the world, so you definitely want to have your music up there. Most of the people, if they want to find your music, if they hear about you, they'll come here and search your name or your artist name. The other cool thing that you can do is create different styles of videos. Instead of your own music, you can upload remixes, you can upload your collaborations, fun videos, tutorials, etc. etc. But if you want to do it simple, then for every video you upload for your album, just use the album artwork and you're done. Upload it and let it stay. At the moment I have 3,000 subscribers, but the problem is that I have this account since 2014. Up until 2019, I only had 400 subscribers. So the growth is very, very, very slow. I would say use YouTube to have it there, but don't pay much attention to it. Upload it, let it be. To set up every single platform, it might take you a whole evening or one day, but you will do it once. After that, you know how everything works, you can repeat it very easily the next time you release something. And that something might be after 3 months or 6 months or 9 months or a year or whatever. So take an evening, upload your music on every platform, and then you're set. As I said earlier, fans listen to music in different platforms. Even if you are an indie artist without a label, even if you just began to make music, you should have your music everywhere. You should make it easy for people to discover you. Don't make it hard. I have fans that listen my music on Deezer. I haven't even touched Deezer. I just use DistroKid, I upload everything there, and it will appear on Deezer for them to enjoy. Now pretty much we covered everything. If you use these platforms, your music will be available to everyone. To people who like to listen on Spotify, to people who like to listen on Bandcamp, to people who like to listen on YouTube, etc. etc. So you won't get lost, create a link tree, which is also free, add all your platforms in here for you to have it and for your fans to pick their favorite. What I do is I have my link tree here on Instagram or in the description of my social media. And if anyone wants to check my stuff, they just click here and they choose their favorite platform. Now let me explain a few things about how Bandcamp pays and how Spotify pays. Fans buy on Bandcamp usually only one time. So if you have an album that costs $3, after taxes it comes to about $2. Okay. From one fan you will get $2. From 10 fans you will get $20. In order to make money to sustain you as an artist, you need to have a huge following. Even with 1,000 followers, let's say those 1,000 followers buy your new album, you will get $2,000. And if you release an album every 3 months or 6 months, well, that cannot sustain you as a musician. Spotify, on the other hand, pays every month. It pays too low, like 0.002 cents. It's extremely low, and for the artist, it's the worst thing, but those plays generate every month and they can add up. If you submit your music on playlists and if you get accepted, then you'll see those plays go up and up and up. For example, in the past, I had like zero plays, for example, for my release. Then I got in touch with a curator. We started talking and they said, okay, I'll give you your music a listen. They did, they added it to their playlist. And after a while, I saw my plays go a bit up. Now, before that, I made $0, nothing. After that, when the plays went up and up, I started making like 50 cents every 3 months. Now, that's funny, the way that I say it. 50 cents after 3 months, it's nothing. It's actually nothing. But it's way better than $0 after 3 months. And eventually, that's what I did. I got in touch with playlist curators. I very politely sent them a message, a short message. I had 2 tracks that I thought that they worked with their playlist and hoped for the best. More often than not, those curators will add your music to their playlists. They also want to find new music to update their playlists, and you getting in touch with them, you are making their job easier. So definitely do it, don't be shy, just be polite and make it short. Eventually, those plays add up, and you can get a good income monthly. Let's compare with Bandcamp. One fan of yours paid $2 and they bought it once. On Spotify, every time they listen to it, it will generate money for you. And eventually, you can get $2 for that album every month. So think about it. One-time payment versus getting paid every month. Now, this is not a comparison of which service is the best. I know people that pay their bills from Bandcamp, and I know people that pay their bills from Spotify. But you want to have varied income from all platforms. You want your Bandcamp to be set up, you want your Spotify to be set up, your iTunes, Amazon Music, everything. You want to have your music everywhere. You need to share every platform that has your music on it to make it easier for your fans to discover it. And eventually you can have an income from Bandcamp, an income from Spotify, sales from iTunes, or I don't know where. Combine all those platforms together and eventually they can give something back to you as an artist in order for you to continue making what you love most, music. If I need to leave you with something, it's this. All those platforms are for the artists. It doesn't matter which one is the best. All do their job. Use everything. And in the future, if you discover a new platform, then upload your music there. You never know what will happen. Even on TikTok, for example. That's all, guys. I hope that helped a bit. Anything you want to ask, just leave a comment below. And if you want me to make more videos like this in the future, let me know. Let me know if you want me to discuss about specific topics, for example. My music, as you have seen, is available everywhere, so pick your favorite platform and go check it out. I recently released an EP called Soul Killer. Thank you for watching. Stay creative.